Hi everyone and welcome back to Creative PowerPoint. Today, we'll build this title reveal animation in PowerPoint. You can use this for your main or intermediate titles. I have this slide that only contains a background image. Let's start by adding our title. I'm using the font Avenir, size 115. Then let's add the subtitle and center it. We'd like to widen the subtitle to match the title width and convey a sense of stability. PowerPoint doesn't have a way to adjust the spacing between letters, also called kerning, but there are two workarounds. The first one is to simply add spaces between letters. For example, 4 spaces between every letter. If not sufficient, add more spaces. This works, but this is not extremely flexible. Let me undo this to present a more flexible option. The second workaround is to put every letter in a separate colon. The word reveal is composed of 6 letters. Right-click on the text box, open the format pane, go to the text options and click on the text box tab. Then set your number of colons and leave the default spacing between colons. Then edit the text inside the text box and between every letter, press the Enter key. That forces every letter to be on its own colon. You can now resize the text box to adjust the kerning. Let's now add and format the horizontal line. We are now ready to work on the reveal animation. The trick relies on cropping combined with a morph transition. Since it's not possible to crop a text box, we will first copy the text box and paste it as a picture. Let's reposition the picture at the right location. Let's do the same for the second text box. You may probably need to retain the original text boxes to be able to make later adjustments to their content. So, instead of deleting them, go to the selection pane and hide them. Let's select the title and in the picture format tab, hit crop. Then drag the bottom crop handle to align it with the white horizontal line. Do the same with the subtitle, this time aligning the top crop handle with the horizontal line. In my case, it's already aligned. Let's now duplicate this slide. On the first slide, select the title. In the picture format tab, press crop, then drag the title down until it's fully invisible. While you're dragging, hold the shift key to ensure the movement is vertical. Select the subtitle and crop it. Drag it up until it's fully invisible. Select the horizontal bar and in the animation tab, add a fly-in effect. Make it fly in from the left-hand side. Set a duration of 1 second and make it start with previous. In the effects option, activate bounce end. To ensure this slide moves automatically to the next one once the animation is complete, go to the Transitions tab, untick on mouse click, and tick After with the value of 0. On the second slide, go to the Transition tab and activate the Morph Transition. Set a transition duration of 1 second. Duplicate the first slide and move it to the end. In the animation pane, remove the fly-in animation for the middle line. Select the middle line, add a split exit animation, and make sure the effect option is set to vertical in. Make sure the animation is set to play with previous, then go to the transitions tab, activate the morph transition, and set a duration of 1 second. Let's play the animation.